extract the missing CIA agent. The target was laying low with the friendly Mujahideen during the vocal cord parasites incident.
That's what we're calling it now.
After the Soviets recaptured it.
Huey's dangerous. Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Dan Plays Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain. I am Metal Gear Solid... I'm Dan. This is Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain. And I don't even remember what I was doing. It was like 2 days ago. But we're resuming. Oh, yes.
Boss, we need evidence to prove our suspicions about Emmerich.
That's right.
Head to the central base camp in Afghanistan and recover that AI pod.
Yeah, sure.
It's time we purge Diamond Dogs of that traitorous parasite once and for all.
Oh, wait. I meant to look at these. Supposedly, I could send out the other thing, the big tank thing, but... I don't see any missions that are like that, so I'm just going to do this one. The success probability is so low. What's the matter with my guys? I guess I need more guys. These are difficulty E. That's like this is one of the hard ones, too. I wish it would let me change stuff. Anyway, let's get more R&D, guys. I don't know. Yeah, this is like a joke. Okay. Let's look at the rewards. Daily rewards. Base facility stuff I know was happening while we were gone. Alright. Can't afford any of that shit. What is the mission here? Like what side ops are here? Mother base. Oh, it's just target practice. Come on. I want to call a helicopter.
Roger.
Let's see if it's like right upstairs, like I'm hoping it is, and not like all the way up top. God damn it.
Roger.
Call it to the wrong one, but you can just change them on the fly, and that's pretty good. Looks like D-Dog knocked him over too. That's funny. Oh yeah, and we have a bunch of tapes to listen to. S-Rank! Alright, let's get out of here. Woof! Need to turn down this volume a little bit. It's a little bit too loud. I feel like it's making me get a little bit too loud. And that's... Actually, that's okay, I guess. I don't know, it depends. Hamburgers of Kazuhira Miller? Like, what the fuck is that about? Skullface, multi-ethnicity of the United States. That all seems like important stuff. Let's see, what can I afford now? Phantom Cigar, Killer Bees, shit like that. I'll reevaluate once I'm landing looking for this AI pod. Alright. Espionage grade.
We need evidence to prove our suspicions about Emmerich. Head to the central base camp in Afghanistan and recover that AI pod. It's time we purge Diamond Dogs of that traitorous parasite once and for all.
Heading to Afghanistan.
That one seemed a little bit too risky. Let's do it. Let's see, what's been going on in my life? Not a whole lot. Working. It's my birthday on Friday. Turning the big 3-0. That's about it. Alright. Site up completed. No, we're just starting. Well, that's no good. Felt like we were looking at D-Dog for a while there. I wonder if... That's the loading screen. It probably is. Alright, I need to look at some development stuff. See what I can discover. Um, Flare supply I don't need. Phantom cigar I don't need. It's like just sneaking stuff. Damage stuff. Right SMG I don't use. Alright.
Be careful down there, boss.
Oh, all I am is careful, my friend. Okay, I think I know where I am. This is like the place where we actually rescued Emmerich. You like that nice little dive? Alright, let's hope D-Dog's doing his thing. And that he's not affected by this sandstorm, which is killing my visibility. Okay. I just like instinctively started to crawl. You gotta crawl before you ball. I think my team is starting to find guys, so did D-Dog.
Enemy presence detected.
But I don't see the marker for these enemies. So, I pretty much know where I'm going. Oh, there he is. I'm supposed to go to Emmerich's lab. Landmines. Trying to keep me from sneaking in that way, I guess. I probably should have put him over here. The way that I'm actually sneaking in. Sandstorm is clearing. Okay, I gotta start getting down or I'm gonna get spotted. Oh, that's just a decoy. I was wondering why D-Dog didn't notice it.
Analysis complete.
A shitty guy. Maybe they want me to come in and do this. I'm pretty sure I already got the thing here. I'm not sure. Yeah, I did. What do we got going on over here?
Analysis complete.
I know how to fucking shoot, game. Are you serious? There we go. Alright, Emmerich's lab was that one over there. So I just gotta slowly make my way that way. Or was this the lab right here? The one that has the door? I think it was.
Analysis complete.
Should stay down because I hear a truck. There it is. Maybe. I guess I could be wrong. What's this guy up to? That's not bad. Let's get across here quickly and quietly. Excellent work, D-Dog. All right, let's see what this guy has to say. It's not the kind of stuff that I care about. You know what? This isn't the place.
He's coming too. Roger that.
No, this is the place. That's definitely the boss. I'm worried. Where is D-Dog? He's like outside.
Philosophers must be reunited. I will devote my skills to that purpose. And with the Colonel's money, I will achieve it. Just as I once created the Colonels.
You're yelling at the dog. Alright, here we go. Uh-oh.
Since you woke up, well, that just might be what's left of our old friend Volgan.
Volgan? No shit. He did kind of look like Volgan. We got tapes on tapes on tapes on tapes.
You mentioned that the man on fire was crushed under Sahelanthropus in its hangar.
Yeah. He was caught under the wheels of its transport platform.
But his body wasn't found.
Right.
What? We searched the area the moment we arrived, but there was no trace of him.
I wasn't hallucinating.
I know. I trust you on that. That means someone must have taken the body. But when I got there, everything was still as it was. Even Skullface hadn't been touched. I can't see a reason to sneak into a place like that and drag out the biggest, heaviest guy there.
What are you getting at?
The only option left is... he got up and walked away.
That platform ran him over.
Just ran him over.
You're saying that's not enough?
I don't want to believe it, but maybe not. He shrugs off bullets, even rocket strikes. There's no reason to think that would finish him. It seems ridiculous, but I'll start gathering eyewitness accounts just in case.
If you dig up anything concrete, I want to know.
You'll be the first, if I dig anything up. But I hope to hell I don't.
No kidding.
Yeah, seriously, that guy was really bad.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Transport. Before we met you, the boss recovered it from a truck crossing the savannah. Are there metallic archaea inside it?
Yes. The archaea metabolize uranium-235 to subsist. They must be stored inside Yellow Cake, or they cannot survive.
Huh.
So those biological traces we took for impurities were actually the real cargo. Of course, they are deactivated. So they do not trigger it.
Roger.
They are like baker's yeast. Yet, they do gradually enrich the uranium as they feed.
Interesting.
I imagine you detected weapons-grade traces.
Yeah, we did. And the malachite that was loaded on the truck had traces of uranium in it, too. So that's the flower, huh? Skullface was gonna sell do-it-yourself new kits. The uranium and
kind of a neat trick.
Complete with the user's manual. And the ores with the uranium could be sourced by the client or provided by Cypher.
Even the
trade
in common ores can be enriched to weapons-grade uranium.
No way.
By the metallic archaea. Proving that must have been the most important factor of the trials. That and the ability to successfully prevent detonation. So
yeah.
If the amounts of uranium in the ores are low enough, they can get past any inspection. And you only need a tiny amount of the archaea to act as the yeast. No great challenge to smuggle that either. The first step towards saturating the world with nukes.
His plan. It's an interesting plan.
That was not my intention. My only goal in developing the metallic archaea was to save the Diné. What made you think a tool for creating undetectable nuclear weapons would save your people?
Yeah.
After 70 years, the Diné reclaimed the Navajo Nation from which we were banished. We bore all the hardships of poverty. But we were proud to live off the land we called our own. But in the moment the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, everything changed.
Yeah, no kidding.
The nuclear arms race between the US and the Soviet Union began with the end of the Second World
War. I'm gonna pause this. It's pretty interesting, the choice to have one of the characters be Navajo, because Navajo is one of the few languages that has no common origin. Plus, that's definitely an example of a people that was oppressed by the English-speaking United States of America, in that, you know, they have, you know, no real sovereignty anymore. The United States was taken from the Native Americans. It's interesting. His choices appear to have some degree of you know, insight when he makes them. Must be a blueprint, maybe? Key item? Strange Love's memento. Makes the bandana available. Bandana, I think, is for infinite ammo. Non-lethal is just that. Gamarga. Decoys, active decoys. I like using these, but I'm trying to save up some cash. Stun arm. Don't really use it that much. There's the bandana. Her bandana, salvaged from Lake Nicaragua. And lovingly repaired. Lowers occurrences of serious injury. I thought it would also give you infinite ammo, but maybe I'm wrong. Looks like we have another vital site op, and it should probably secure the remains of the man on fire. I'll land over here. Same equipment loadout. I'm going to, I probably could have taken just the little path thing there. Oh well, whatever. Dumpsters, toilets, hiding on horseback. The box trick. It's not a trick, but the box teleporter. Alright. And then we'll start playing this 3-minute clip again. Okay, here we go. It was in Metallic Archaea.
What made you think a tool for creating undetectable nuclear weapons would save your people? After we bore all the hardships of poverty. But we were proud to live off the land we called our own. But in the moment the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, everything changed. I don't get it. The nuclear arms race between the U.S. and the Soviet Union began with the end of the Second World War. Suddenly, there was a massive demand for uranium.
Oh, which is in their place.
Our ill fortune that the ground beneath the Navajo Nation was rich with uranium ore.
That sucks.
The Blackana government set up mine after mine, and many of the Diné worked danger. Every day, they went to work with no protection.
Oh, jeez.
The flag was simply piled out in the open.
That's
when
shitty.
Rain fell, uranium traces left behind would seep out. And when the ground dried, it was blown about as dust. Land and water were contaminated. Irradiated. Many of us became sick and died.
So this, like, consumes it? Or I thought it created it, too.
Lives on to this day. I have no idea. Wanting more than anything to revive the land my forebears left to me. I was delighted upon discovering microbes that eat uranium. If they
domesticated,
I believed we could rid our land of uranium.
Were you successful?
No. The research called for funding on a colossal scale. But nobody was willing to invest with no prospect of a return.
And that's when Skullface showed up.
Correct. I can save you and your people. We share the same will. That is what he said to me. And I believed him. Blagana forced me to abandon my uranium cleanup work and focus on nuclear weapons. And he held all the Diné hostage. Today, the uranium mines within the reservation are finally closing down. It is simply less expensive now to source uranium overseas.
New victims, different places.
But yeah, uranium is a tactical resource. To rely on a foreign country for it is a difficult decision to make.
Yeah, seriously.
And she was in the perfect place to influence that decision.
He could have condemned your people to the mines forever.
Analysis. The contamination comes not only from uranium. The fallout from the Nevada nuclear tests also settled on our lands.
Yeah.
As if our fortune were not already bad enough. We are also downwinders. To save the Diné, I must complete my original research.
Plant expansion. You know what's actually... I think I want Scout.
Please select a
Scout. I think I want Quiet.
Buddy, departing area of operations.
Did I lose all my markings? Yeah, I did. At least all the dog ones. Sucked.
The map has been updated.
Alright, looks like she's in. Let's see if I can get away with this. Oops.
Fire at will.
Let her do her thing now.
Leave the rest to us.
While they're distracted.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Hey. She's just taking them all out.
Come here! Come here!
decoys. I find it hard to believe that they'd be up here, but gotta start clearing out, folks.
Complete.
Looks like they saw my shot. Jeez. Thanks for the save, Quiet. Could have been bad.
Subject on board.
Oops, I'm forgetting to like interrogate these guys, find out where that body is. Let's get this guy. Not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the remains. Maybe I gotta look inside myself. So I'll do that. Have her keep covering me. Perfect. I guess I don't have to worry at all anymore, really. Here are the guys who I wanted to capture earlier. Let's ask this guy what's up.
He's coming too. Roger.
That's not what I want. I'm gonna look on this right side here first for his remains. I'm like really worried that he's gonna ignite though. That's kind of why I'm like trying to make sure that I knock these guys out first, because I'm afraid I'm gonna have a fight on my hands. All right. I like running around on their little desks. Nothing doing in here. Thought the outpost was captured. Fucking A, man. See what we got here.
Analysis complete.
You're a piece of shit.
Extraction failed.
I'm not bothered by it. It must mean that he's in here though. Maybe. I guess this would have been a nice spot for a Diamond Dog to help me know that I was walking into an ambush. I hear her running around. Still not seeing anything here. There's somebody stunned over there. Blow the shit up. I like blowing it up. I bet he fell. Oh, no, that's the guy I knocked out. Who's this gentleman over here? Gotta do a little better than that, quiet.
Clouds approaching.
You gotta extract him.
All right. So he's not on this side. Let's try this side, I guess. A prison cell back here. He doesn't look like he's here either. Could he be in one of the other things? Like, sort of the outpost is a, like a trick. Wherever he is, it's not here. Yeah, none of these machines. Yeah, maybe he's somewhere else. There are landmines over there. Let's go check it out. Grab this thing in case I didn't grab it.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
She knocked out a bunch of these guys, but none of these guys are the man on fire. Well, I can ask one of them where he is. I want.
The map has been updated.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
I wasn't even trying to capture the truck. Landmines here, but I was really worried that it would kill me. I wonder if you can do this. Looks like you can. Cool, diamonds. Not even in the soles of my shoes. Where is he? It's annoying when they don't tell you where he is. some sort of threat over here. I'll be damned if I see it. Okay, where else could it be? Is there like a chamber I missed? Where is it? What's left to look? I haven't been up there. I doubt he's up there though. Man on fire. Ollie, Ollie, oxen free. I think he can give me some resources. Some huts over here. It just, it doesn't make sense for him to be here. Alright, what do we got? Process materials. I gotta go back into the prison. Look a little bit harder. These aren't open, nope. You know what? Why did I stop playing cassettes? This would have been perfect time to have cassettes playing.
The one that covers the parasite that lives on the surface of the skull's bodies is what gives them their power. Similar to my children who live in my skin. I modified the parasites I isolated from the body of that old man, differentiating them with various abilities. One that can blend perfectly into its surroundings by exposing the
pigments
in its cells at will. Another that, by harboring multiple species of metallic archaea, can oxidize and reduce metal. Isolating the one that covers and transplanting it into an artificial medium should provide the same abilities as the skulls, but they can only subsist within a human body. Once transplanted into the medium, they will eventually die. Another thing, the weakness of the one that covers is desiccation. Their surface moisture loss is greater
than ours. They need water.
The reason they give off mist is to alleviate this by releasing the salts inside them as microparticles. Water vapor condenses around them, appearing as mist.
Interesting.
This dries out the atmosphere until they cannot even produce mist. And once their supply of water from the host runs out, the parasites are in danger. They, along with their host,
I feel stupid now. I'm gonna wait for this tape to finish.
A similar effect occurs if they come into contact with a large amount of water. Rain, for instance, the one that covers will temporarily abandon other processes in its eagerness to absorb the water.
So I wonder if we should call in rain against.
Make the weather your ally.
I will. Let's see if it really is Volgin. His face is like burned off, but it looks like him. Usually what happens, it usually goes much faster than that. Whoops. Wait, what? Uh-oh. His face just came back. Where was my eye patch? What just happened? I am so lost. And now he's back to, like, the burnt motherfucker, look. I need to go back to Mother Base.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
It might make me, anyway. But we never resolved anything that happened after we got the AI pod back.
I barely recognize you, Colonel. Stoneface used your thirst for revenge against Big Boss, did he?